Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you so much for always watching. So let's dive in the reader here again. Romans. We are in the book of Romans. Romans chapter 1, starting from verse 16. That's amazing. We've started from verse 1. We are verse 16 now. So let's dive in. It says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jews first, and also to the Greek, to the whole wild world, everyone that believeth." Gospel is the power of Christ, is the power of God to salvation. Before you can be saved, you must know the gospel, you must hear the gospel before you believe. And that is the power of God unto salvation. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Verse 17 says, "For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith." Everything we do is by faith. There's a Bible verse that says that if we don't do anything by faith, it's a sin. All we do is by faith. We pray, we worship, we read the word of God, we believe the Spirit, we believe the word of what God is saying. Everything is by faith. And we have all been given a measure of faith. If you believe in anything, you have faith. Just put that energy or that faith in the good way, like believing in Christ Jesus. That is the best way to utilize your faith. We all have faith. We all believe in something. Verse 18 says, "For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness." They hold on the truth, but in unrighteousness, like me coming here to be preaching the Bible, saying things about word of God, but me myself, I am unrighteous. You see, so I know who I am in Christ Jesus. I know I am the righteousness of God. That's why Bible says you come boldly to the throne of mercy, to the throne of grace, to obtain mercy every single time. Every single time, we are the righteousness of God. I am the righteousness of God. Say to yourself that you are the righteousness of God, and you hold on to that truth with that consciousness that you are the righteousness of God, and not holding on to the truth with the mind that I am unrighteous, with the mind that, oh, Father, have mercy. Yes, Father, our Father has mercy, has had mercy on us, and you continue to have mercy, especially when you are a believer, you are in his righteousness, in Christ Jesus. God bless you. God loves you so much. Put that in your subconscious mind to know that you are the righteousness of God, and we'll hold on to that truth with that thought that we are the righteousness of God, and by faith, we'll begin to walk in that righteousness of God. God bless you so much.